Hi, I'm State Senator Rob Ortt. Thanks for joining me for my Week in Review as I take you through some of the work I've been doing in Albany and the events I took part in over this past Memorial Day weekend. The observation of Memorial Day began with the rededication of a roadway honoring the brave soldiers from the Twin Cities who never returned home from the Vietnam War. Twin Cities Memorial Highway will now be known as Twin Cities Vietnam Veterans Memorial Highway. This name change pays respect to the Vietnam vets and is long overdue recognition of their service. It's important to remember all our heroes in the armed forces who have died fighting for and defending our rights and freedoms. Those fallen soldiers who have bravely served our great country were honored in municipalities throughout my district over the Memorial Day weekend. I took part in several commemorative ceremonies held in Lewiston, Wilson, Newfane, and the Tonawandas. The Twin Cities, North Tonawanda and Tonawanda, held its annual Memorial Day parade following a solemn service at sea ceremony on the Renaissance Bridge. Gold Star Father Phil Soranowski threw a wreath of flowers into the canal in memory of his son, Lance Corporal Tim Soranowski, who I recently inducted into the State Veterans Hall of Fame. I salute all the military men and women who have paid the ultimate sacrifice so that we can enjoy what we have today. In Albany, I welcomed Consul General of Canada John Prado to the state capitol. Our neighbors to the north share a strong military, cultural, and economic bond. We discussed strengthening these bonds to benefit Canada and New York State. I also had the opportunity to tour the Wildwood School with my colleague, Senator George Amador. Wildwood provides incredible services to children and adults with autism spectrum disorders and disabilities. I was certainly touched by the perseverance of their students, teachers, and workers. Lastly, the Senate passed its bill to make the property tax cap permanent, but we still need the State Assembly majority to take action. This year alone, property owners in Western New York are expected to save a total of nearly $186 million on school taxes due to the cap. You can show your support by heading to my website at ort.nysenate.gov to join our online Keep the Cap campaign. Thanks again for joining me this week. I'm Rob Ortt. Good luck and God bless.